Welcome to EPG Pathshala. In this module, we will be studying diode rectifiers. There are various types of diode rectifiers which are widely used in power electronic circuits. It is the most basic power electronic circuit. One can categorize power rectifiers according to the type of input, single phase and three phase rectifiers. In this module, we will be studying single phase rectifier circuit. Single phase rectifier circuits can be categorized according to the type of the circuit. For example, half wave rectifier, center trap full wave rectifier, and third is bridge rectifier. Among these three, the bridge rectifier is considered to be the best. So why it is best? So one can talk about this on the basis of performance parameters. Performance parameters are best in case of bridge rectifiers. After studying bridge rectifiers, we will be studying all these types of rectifiers with other types of load. For example, highly inductive load. Highly inductive load is the widely used load in most of the industrial applications. After studying this, we will be studying types of filters. So where we require types of filters? Will require types of filter at the output side of the diode rectifier and input side of the diode rectifiers. Output side rectifiers are called as DC filters, whereas input side rectifiers are called as AC filters. After studying this, we will end this module. What are rectifiers? What is the function of rectifier? Rectifier converts AC voltage into DC voltage. There are various types of rectifier, single phase and polyphase rectifiers. In polyphase rectifiers, mainly three-phase rectifiers are used. In single-phase rectifier, there are three types of rectifiers, half-wave, center-tap, full-wave, and bridge rectifiers. There are various applications of diode rectifier circuit, since it is a most basic circuit. Diode rectifiers are widely used in DC power supplies, SMPS, DC motor drives, stepper motor drives, and almost in every electronic instrument and appliances. Single phase rectifiers, we will be studying half wave, center tap, full wave, and bridge rectifier. For example, let us consider the half wave rectifier. It consists of one diode connected to the load in series, as shown in figure. There is transformer which is used for the isolation. When input voltage of the input is positive, then diode will conduct and it will give the output. So input voltage will come at the output. During negative half cycle, the diode will be reverse biased and it will give no output. The timing waveforms are shown in this timing waveform diagram. Whereas in center tap full wave rectifiers, the things are different. It consists of transformer. Now here one diode is increased, there are two diodes and the load. The transformer of this circuit is different. It has two phases as shown in figure. It is called a center tap transformer. So during positive cycle, diode D1 will be on and we will get the output which is positive. During negative half cycle, D1 will be off, D2 will be on, and you will get the positive voltage as shown in timing waveform. Now it is clear that here DC output voltage is increased, but it is also observed that during turn off condition, the diode is highly reverse biased, that voltage is minus 2 Vm. Now we will see the third circuit, that is bridge rectifier. In bridge rectifier, simple transformer is used, but two diodes are increased than center tap configuration. There are four diodes in which diodes are connected in bridge form and load is connected. Here, output ground is different and secondary is different. In the first two cases, secondary terminal is connected to the ground, but it is not the case in this circuit. During positive half cycle, diode D1 and D2 will be turned on and path will be completed through output resistor, that is load R, as shown in figure. You will get the positive output. During negative half cycle, current will be reversed and current will be flown through D3, R and D4, and it will be returned. So you will get the positive voltage. If you see the output voltage of this is similar to the center tap full wave rectifier, but there is change in the diode voltage when diode is off. Diode voltage is much lesser than center tap configuration. This is the full timing waveform of bridge rectifier. The quality of the diode rectifier circuits generally is done according to various performance parameters. To determine those performance parameters, we will require the knowledge of the input voltage and input currents. First, we will determine these quantities. The input quantities are, in most of the cases, input voltage and input current. If you know the input voltage and input current, we can determine the input power, which is AC power, that is Vs into Is. The input is, in most of the cases, purely AC. Voltage is AC, but the input current, we cannot talk about the type of the input current. It may be AC, it may be DC. Output quantities are the V0 and I0, that is output voltage and output current. So from output voltage waveform and output current waveform, one can determine the average value of output voltage and average value of output current. From this, we can determine the output power, which is DC power. But it is not pure DC, so it has some ripple. So therefore, one has to determine the RMS values of those. From these waveforms, one can determine the RMS value of voltage and current. From this, we will know about the output AC power. From these six quantities, we can determine most of the performance parameter. So we will define first the performance parameters. First is efficiency. Efficiency is nothing but output DC power divided by output AC power. Then second parameter is form factor, is nothing but RMS voltage of the output divided by DC voltage of the output. From form factor, one can determine the ripple factor. And transformer utilization factor is the most important performance parameter in this. The ideal values are also shown in this table. Transformer utilization factor determines the size of the transformer, that's why it is important. It also determines the cost of the transformer. So it is the output DC power versus input AC power. Then the crest factor. The crest factor is mainly dependent on peak value of input current or source current. These are the factors which can determine all these quantities which are already defined. Now there is another important part, that is displacement factor. Displacement factor is related to power factor. It is defined as cos phi. What is phi? Phi is nothing but the phase difference between input voltage and input current. Obviously, input voltage and input current at fundamental frequency. In most of the cases, output contains harmonics. So that's why there is need of power factor. So power factor is defined by IS1 upon IS into cos phi, where IS1 is the fundamental component of the input current. The power factor ideal value is 1. Practically, it should be close to 1. Then harmonic factor. Harmonic factor, ideally it should be 0. It is nothing but the harmonic content at the input. Then there is another parameter which is related to diode. instead of circuit, the peak inverse voltage of a diode. The peak inverse voltage of a diode is nothing but the maximum voltage which comes across a diode during turn-off condition. There is another parameter which is used, which is related to the ripple voltage, that is pulse number. Pulse number is defined as ripple frequency divided by the source frequency or input frequency. On the basis of this parameter, one can talk about the quality of the rectifiers. Now, to determine these rectifier parameters, first we should determine the RMS and DC voltages. First, we will see how to determine the RMS voltage. For example, we will take example of half wave rectifier. From the output waveform, one can determine the RMS of the load voltage as follows. So it is root mean square. So in this way, one can determine the RMS values. Then one can determine the DC value or average value of the output voltage according to this formula. So using these types of formulas, one can determine the Vs, Is. These values are given in this table. So one can see here that in center type and bridge rectifiers, the output voltages are higher than half wave rectifier. So from this, we can determine the parameters. From this parameter, one can see that for half wave rectifier, efficiency is 40% in center tap and bridge, it is increased, it is doubled. In form factor also, decrease in center tap and bridge condition. Ripple factor is obviously, it will be low for bridge and center tap case. The main difference is the transformer utilization factor. So if we compare this, we will get it is around 28%. For center tap, it is 57%, and for bridge, it is 81%. Here, the answer is here. So why people use bridge rectifier? Because transformer utilization factor is 81%, which is the maximum among these three, because it decides the size of the transformer. So therefore, the cost of the rectifier. Crest factor, power factor, peak inverse voltage and pulse number are shown in this table. These things are only analyzed for purely resistive load. Now, this is the circuit of half wave rectifier, but here the load is changed. The RL load is used here. During half cycle, the output current, which delays by some time. The output current is delayed. When input voltage goes zero, the diode current cannot become zero because of inductive load. So therefore, you get output voltage halfway rectified in the first half cycle. But during negative half cycle, the current will still continue and output voltage will go negative also. The waveforms are as shown in figure. Now, if you see the output voltage, the DC contents of the output voltage is highly reduced because of highly inductive load. So therefore, this circuit is not used as it is. So there is another problem with this circuit is that when diode turns off, so because of back EMF of the inductor, diode D1 may damage because inductor voltage reverses during turn off. To avoid this type of problem, generally additional diode is used, which is called as freewheeling diode. If you connect freewheeling diode as shown in this figure, so in positive half cycle, the current shown in the figure, current will not become zero immediately. But during negative half cycle, so output voltage will reverse. Therefore, diode DM, which is called as free-wheeling diode, conducts. So therefore, current will still continue through load, even though diode D1 is turned off. Now we can see the output DC voltage is increased in this case. Now, if we see the source current in this case, source current and output current are different. So, during positive half cycle, load takes current from the source. During negative half cycle, whatever energy which is stored in the inductor, that will be used and that will be converted into the current. Now, half wave rectifiers can be also used as a battery charger. So, this is the diagram of battery charging circuit. Resistor R is used for the current limit. During positive half cycle, diode will be turned on when input voltage is greater than the battery voltage E. The waveforms are as shown in the figure. During negative half cycle, battery will not be charged because diode will be reverse biased. So now we will be studying the bridge rectifier with RLE load. RLE load is as shown in the figure. Now, why RLE load? Why it is analyzed? Because RLE load is nothing but the electrical equivalent circuit of DC motor, armature of the DC motor. So, we will analyze. So, R is the resistance, L is the inductance, and E is the DC voltage. If DC voltage is zero, how will be the waveform? The waveforms are shown as in the figure. Now, if there is some DC voltage present, E has a finite value. So, it is shown in the timing waveforms. Now, in this case, diodes will not be on for 0 to pi. So, diode will turn on during the angle beta minus alpha. Now, in practice, output load is not directly connected to the rectifier, because we have seen in this module there is much ripple in all types of circuits. So, how to reduce this ripples? So, you will require filters at the output side. So, there are different filters which are used in practice to reduce the ripple voltage and to increase the DC contents. The most widely used is shunt capacitor filter. Shunt capacitor filter is used as shown in figure. So, capacitor is connected in parallel with the load resistor or load. So, one can see from the timing waveform, DC contents are increased. Another important filter is series inductor filter. This is used for higher currents. If currents are high, then this type of filters is used. But here the average voltage is slightly reduced and current ripple is high. But current is also reduced because of inductor. So, it will reduce the high end rush current. The DC content can be increased using LC filters. LC filter reduces the ripple and increases the DC content as shown in figure. This ripple can be still reduced using CLC filter as shown in figure. Now, we will compare all this type of filter. CLC filter is also called as pi section. These are the comparison. The comparison of the rectifier filters is shown in this table. Cost of shunt filter shunt C filter is low. So, but the disadvantage is very high in rush current. So, one can see, one can go through all these comparisons, and from this it is clear that pass section filter among this is comparatively better than other types of filter. Now, because of this, even though filters are used, the input current shape is different for different types of circuits. So, therefore, input contains the harmonics. So, this harmonics may affect the input voltage itself. To avoid this, we will require some types of filters. We will take an example of a rectifier with LC filter. Now, if you see the timing waveform of output and input current, so output current is constant, but input current is almost square wave. So, since it is square wave, it contains so many harmonics. So, how to avoid these harmonics? It means input contains harmonic power. How to reduce that power? For that power, we will require the filters at input side. So, generally, LC filters are used at the input sides. So, these LC filters are used to eliminate or to bypass the higher frequencies, which are harmonic frequencies. So, this is one type of filters which is used, and most widely filter is used is T filter, as shown in the figure. That is, it contains two inductors and one capacitor, and shown in the figure.